In this video, let us understand about the deciles, which means divides, series into 10 equal parts. So, in case of individual and discrete series, what you will do, you will simply do n. In order to find out the decile 1, we will find out the size of n plus 1 by 10 item. Then if you have to find out decile 2, 2 into n plus 1 by 10th item. Then decile 3, 3 n plus 1 by 10th item. And so on. If you have to find out decile 8, it will be 8 n plus 1 by 10th item. If it's decile 9, which means 9 n plus 1 by 10th item. So in this case, this is how you find out the deciles in the case of individual and discrete series. Arrange the data in the ascending or descending order. And find out the deciles. Now in continuous series, how you will do? You will first find the cumulative frequency of the series. Then whatever the decile is asked for from you, let's suppose the decile 3 is asked. So you'll do 3 n by 10th item. So then you will find the item in the cumulative frequency and you will find out the decile class. Now what you will do, in order to find the decile 3, you will use this formula. You find out the decile class, that then the lower limit of decile class plus 3 divided by 10th minus CF, cumulative frequency of the preceding decile class, frequency of the decile class into I, the size of the decile class. If you have to find out the decile 6, same way, 6, 10th item, decile 6 is lower limit of the decile class, 6 n by 10 minus cumulative frequency divided by frequency of the decile class into I. This is how you can find out any decile they want by multiplying it simply here. So this is how you find the deciles in the continuous series. I hope you have understood the deciles. Do download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.